Now, we will start coding for our game. This is the interface that I have got from CS First website, that is unit number 1, gaming story. But as I don't require this particular sprite, so I will be deleting it. But before deleting it, I will give the name. So the name has to be Final Project My Name with grade 6A. I will be giving 6A, and now I will be deleting both the sprites as I am not requiring this particular sprite at all. So what I will be doing, first I will be selecting a backdrop. I will be going in the backdrops over there, and this is my backdrop. What I will be doing, I will be just putting a red color border. I'm just creating a border at the base. So now I will be creating a border over here. Done, and I'll be increasing it so that it covers the entire stage now. Now, at least my backdrop is ready. If I want to make changes to the color, definitely I will be able to make changes in it. Yes, so now done. Now my backdrop is ready. Now I'll go to the code part. Next, what I require a sprite. So I'll go to the sprite option over there. After going to the sprite option over there, I will be giving a search option as in title. Basically, I'm creating a bouncing game over there. So I will be creating a title, and the size of the title is too small. So I will make the size as 150, and I'll put this particular title onto the red area, that is a base area. Now, at least the base part is ready, the foundation part for the coding is ready. Now, first I will just make the coding part for the bat. First, I will be going in the events. Under events, I will be clicking on the green flag. Again, I'll go under the motion block. I require to set the position. What is the position of the y-axis over here? As you are able to see, it is -140. So under motions, I will see where is set instruction. Yes, set y to -140. And then I'll go under control instructions. Under control block, I will select forever instructions. Now I require to move this particular pedal on the back on the left hand side and the right hand side. The left hand side and the right hand side can be given with the help of x axis. So over here I have to select the x axis. So how to select the x axis? Again, go under motions. After going under the motions, I will be selecting set x to, and I will be giving it under this remove 55. That means the block is empty now. Now I will be going under sensing. In sensing, you will be able to see move x. Now let's click on the green flag and see. Yes, my bat is working fine. It is moving to the x-axis. It is moving on the positive x-axis, and it is moving to the negative x-axis. See, as I'm moving over here, you are able to see it is -240. And over here, sorry, over on the right-hand side, it is +240. And on the right-hand side, it will be -240. So at least the coding part for the bat has been done. Now what I require, in order to do the coding part, I require another sprite over there. So definitely I'll be selecting another sprite, and I'm selecting a ball over there. If you want to change the color of the ball, move up from the costume. You will be able to see there are different kinds of ball. I will be selecting any one color, and then come in the code part again. In the code part, first of all, again, when green flag is clicked, done. Now, after this particular part, my dear kids, I will be going under the motion block. And under the motion block, I will be setting go to x and y as 0, 0. We all are aware 0, 0 is, it is nothing but the center coordinate of the screen. So my ball will be exactly at the center of the screen. I will be putting it 0 over here. See, if I put x and y as 0, 0, what happens? Your ball exactly moves to the center of the screen. Now, where I have to go, my dear kids? I will be going under the option again, block motion. Under motion, I will be able to see instruction that is point and direction. Replace this 90. It is blank over there. Then I will be going under operator. Under operator, over here you will be able to see pick random. Pick random from 0 to 360. That means the ball can be moving anywhere between 0 to 360 degrees. Now, come under the control block. In the control block, you will be able to see an instruction called as forever. Now, what happens in the forever block? Now, there are different parts in the forever block. One by one, we are going to clear all the parts. Under the forever, we will be using if. So, I'm making use of if. Condition. Now, what is the condition? Touching color. You all remember we have used touching color. So, touching color is present in the sensing block. Touching color, I will be dragging this touching color and making it fit into the diamond. Now, touching color what? Touching color at the base. Then, so when it touches at the base, what happens? It should broadcast a message. It should broadcast a message. Now, what is the message over there? So, come in the control block. Come in the events block. In the event block, you will be able to see broadcast message 1 and drag it at the top. Now, what happens when the ball will touch the paddle? So, again over there, I require one if instruction. So, again, I will be going under the... This is the second if block. If. Then, again... Go under the motions, and under the motions you will be able to see you have to go under sensing if touching. Touching what? If touching the paddle, then what should happen? The ball should get rotate. Then because when we are touching a particular ball with the help of a bat, the rotation of the ball occurs. So over here it will be 90 degrees. And now let's see how it runs over there. There is a certain glitch in the program. Let us correct it. Now, there is more instructions over there. I have to put motions move. Then, so I will be putting move 4. Move 4 steps, and I will be going under motions if on edge bounce. If on edge bounce. Now, one more time, we will be playing this particular part, my dear kids. You are able to see now the ball is bouncing and it is moving up. So, I'll stop this particular part. Now, I will be including one more variable over here. Now, the variable that I'm making use of is variable. Make a variable. The name of the variable will be score. Click on OK. Yes, so the score is 0. So, initially set score to 0. And when it touches the paddle, the score should increase by 1. So, change the score by 1. Then, let's see how this particular part will work now. Score is 0. When I touch it, definitely twice it has been touched. So it is increasing by 2. then you are able to see that yes, it is going up. Still, there are certain blocks which are remaining. Now what will happen when the ball will touch the red part? So when the ball will touch the red part, all the blocks should stop. So when? Then I receive message 1. Message 1 is nothing but when it will touch the red part. What happens over there? We should stop. So stop is there in the control block. Stop all. And change this particular stop all to other script in the sprite. And then again stop. And then all will be converted to this sprite. And then I'm dragging this to the padlet area and dragging this to the stage area itself. That means entire thing should get stopped. Play one more time. You are able to see that now since the ball is touching the red area, it will stop. Done. So this was all about the game. You can modify this particular game also. You can make use of one of the sprites. I will be making use of one of the sprites. I will be creating a sprite and I will be typing game over here. Game over. And if you want, just increase the size, take it to the center of the stage and do the coding for the game over. Now, what is the coding for the game over, my dear kids? It is very, very simple. Just click on when green flag is clicked. When green flag is clicked, what will happen? Go under the looks block. Under the looks block, you will be able to see an option called as hide. So we have to click on hide, and under the events block, when I receive message, again it will go under the looks block and show. So one is hide, one is show. Let's start with the gaming part and see how it is done. I'm not going to play. I'll just stop it so that the ball touches the red area and see what will happen then. When it touches the red area, you are able to see game over, the score is zero and everything is there. Done. So in this particular manner, I have inputted maximum of the blocks that we have learned during the sync session. Done. And it is a complete game with a variable with game over. So in this particular part, your game should be relevant. Your game should be complete. There should be certain creativity. If you want, you can put more creativity. This was just a sample from the teacher's side. We are just imagining how on the other side being there. That means we have played this particular role of being a student, and you can design this particular game at So we have just played the role of a student and we have designed the game in order to show you in a much better manner exactly what are the things that was expected from your side, my dear kids. Thank you.